Hello and welcome to Let's Read the Books of the Gagharv Trilogy. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. We're on board the Tirada, and today I'll be reading Captain Thomas's Great Sea Adventures. Captain Thomas's Great Sea Adventures. The sea is shining under the morning sun. It is the Emerald Sea, the most beautiful of the seven seas. Seagulls fly and dolphins swim around playfully. A ship is thrusting forward through the waves, with its white sails fully extended. It is the Planetos, or the white migratory bird commanded by Captain Thomas. This day the Planetos is again traveling freely over the sea. Captain Thomas finally finds the secret den of the pirate king, Ramon. Who would have thought that his hideout was in this beautiful Emerald Sea? I will never let him get away this time, murmurs Captain Thomas determinedly. He stands on the deck, reflecting the morning sun, his muscular, tanned arms pulsating with tension and glowing reddish-brown. The battle will be held in the evening, 1,200 milos southwest of Pirate Island. The Planetos sails smoothly, and by a little after lunch, the ship is in the target area. Thomas has fought many times against Ramon, but never in Ramon's own turf. Who knows what Ramon might have in store? He lowers the anchor and puts his men on watch. Near sundown, a fleet led by Ramon appears. Ramon has six ships, each equipped with large cannons. The Planetos also has cannons, but it is heavily outnumbered. However, Captain Thomas has no intention of turning tail and fleeing. Today we shall fight until one of us wins. The final battle between Thomas and Ramon is about to begin on the Emerald Sea, golden under the setting sun. Ramon's ships open fire with their cannons. The cannons emit thunderous noises, but the cannonballs fall short of their mark. Thomas turns his ship around and takes a windward position. We lost the windward position, screams Ramon in rage. His ships can no longer hope to hit the Planetos with cannon fire. However, Captain Thomas's plan has only just started. Full sails, he shouts. The sails extend from the mast like blooming white flowers. The Planetos lurches forward like a cannonball. Once the Planetos was riding the wind, there was no stopping it. Ram and board the enemy ship. Prepare for melee combat. Following a sharp turn, the Planetos speeds straight towards Ramon's flagship. The Planetos showers cannonballs at any ship which tries to bar its way, sinking three before ramming into the flagship. Captain Thomas, you scheming little rat! Ramon stomps his feet in rage. The Planetos smashes into the side of Ramon's flagship. Board the ship! Jump over! An all-out melee breaks out between the crews of the two ships, now locked in a deadly embrace. As Ramon's flagship starts to sink, Thomas runs throughout the ship, looking for his nemesis. Ramon, where are you? Come and face me. Suddenly, Ramon attacks Thomas from behind, screaming a fearsome battle cry. Thomas narrowly dodges Ramon's sword. You coward! Sparks fly from their swords as the two captains trade blows. The half-sunken ship begins to tilt sharply. Ramon, your end is nigh. We'll see about that. I won't die alone. Ramon, as a last resort, lights a fuse leading to the gunpowder stock on his ship. Everyone, abandon ship! Thomas shouts as he jumps overboard. A thundering explosion blows the two ships to smithereens. And thus, Captain Thomas's final voyage came to an end. Seafarers were no longer plagued by the pirates. Yet no one ever saw Captain Thomas again. When we see migratory birds flying, we will always be reminded of the brave captain of the Planetos. The man who sailed the seven seas, the one and only Captain Thomas. The end. Thank you for listening to Let's Read the Books of the Gagharv Trilogy, Captain Thomas's Great Sea Adventures.